Welcome, listeners. I am the voice of this show, the synthesized voice of your dear host, Geoff. In this episode, we are going to dive deeper into the Bosch technology that makes battery recycling more efficient. Today, Bosch associate Sebastian Krieger will introduce the digital twin of the batteries and a guidance system for workers. Because recycling batteries from electric vehicles is a challenge on its own. Bosch Rexroth is known for their factory automation know-how, among other things. Sebastian and his team look at solutions for recycling as if it were a production process. Production in reverse. So they are bringing concepts and processes from manufacturing to the recycling industry. An industry that typically uses much rougher tools and stronger machinery than production facilities.
You have to have a way of dealing with some hazardous and dangerous things full of energy. You cannot use the brutal things you use normally. So to bring manufacturing technology to something where you would not expect it in that way. And I think that's the interesting thing, how manufacturing technology is going into recycling in a way which benefits both.
Sebastian sees many commonalities between building a battery and dismantling it. He and his team apply the latest ideas from the production to the recycling world.
When we talk in the factory of the future about how do we have lot size one as a challenge for manufacturing, here we come to the point that we have nearly lot size one, but in the other way around.
There is a huge variance in electric vehicle models and batteries in them. On top of that, each battery has its own history. That means each battery that enters the facility is unique.
First, you don't know exactly the status of this battery. It has been used, it has wear and tear, it has a different profile, usage profile. So you have to first do a diagnosis to understand what is the status of this battery, if you can easily dismantle it mechanically or it's difficult because, for example, the screws are corroded.
This initial diagnosis is key. Crucial data is collected that determines how the battery will move through the recycling process. For instance,
state of health, state of charge, conditions, pictures, origin.
In the future, some data could even come from car workshops that service the car. Data could be extracted from the vehicle control unit to learn more about the history of a battery. All of this data forms a digital twin of the battery. Measurements and data from the following recycling process steps complete the picture. Having this virtual representation of each battery is a key component of the recycling process, says Sebastian.
At the end of the day, you have only the different parts, like the copper and the cables and the battery management system and the cells. But in the digital world, you can see still the different layers of what was originally the battery.
The battery disappears piece by piece. But the digital twin remains. It helps keep track.
If you collect all the copper cables and put them in one big bag, then you just look into it and you see a bag full of cables. But digitally, you see it's also an entity full of cables, but you can see, okay, it was from model A, the cable A, and from model B, the cable A, and from model B, the cable B. And so you have like a display what is actually in, but when you look physically in it, you see just a bunch of cables.
The digital twin follows the battery through the process from beginning to end, from the initial diagnosis to the shredder. When looking at the batteries being dismantled, it's hard to tell one battery apart from the next. So how does the system keep track?
You also need a workpiece carrier, a physical workpiece carrier, which is transporting the different things. Even if you take a part away, it remains on the workpiece carrier and the workpiece carrier is following it. And then you take one part away, you put it on the other workpiece carrier and data is following with the physical part on this. But digitally, it remains one part.
The workpiece carriers have markers that the system can identify. That way it knows which parts of which battery are moving through the facility on which carrier. The digital twin is used for more than just tracking materials and record keeping. It has a crucial role to play when humans dismantle parts of the batteries. In the process that Bosch Rexroth has developed, workers get assistance from the digital twin. Or rather, a worker guidance system that displays the digital twin's data. Workers can see information about the battery currently in front of them on a screen.
We can have pictures of the real pack there as an instruction, and it's really marking where are the different points.
Unplug this cable there. Remove these screws. Make sure there's no electricity at this point.
And then you can also include measurement information, and then you see the measurement curve, and then you see maybe a threshold, and if it's over there, the routine has to follow the one way. If it's under this threshold, it goes to the different way.
The worker guidance system assists workers in handling a huge variance in different batteries. The total number of batteries that need to be recycled is still relatively small. Meanwhile, there are already a multitude of different models. No human can get the training and experience to handle each battery appropriately. The worker guidance system, however, can pull data from a large library of batteries. It also knows how to handle a battery based on the data from the initial diagnosis.
And with a dedicated worker guidance system, we increase the safety of the workers.
Safety is important when you handle hazardous materials and things that can be electrically charged. The system only allows actions that are safe.
We have also measuring devices, for example, for the electricity, can measure it, and then the software recognizes the value. And if the value is below a certain threshold, for example, we then release a screwdriver that can unscrew something. And if it's too dangerous, it's not released for operation half.
In that case, the battery would have to get discharged first and then come back. You might have noticed some tasks in the recycling process are done by humans, others by machines. That is another way how the dismantling of the batteries mirrors their production.
In the manufacturing, there are some processes which can be automated because they're repeatable, but others are difficult to automate. For example, closing the lid onto the pack and screwing in, that's something you see automated in production. So you can do the same in the dismantling or the disassembly process. Other processes like putting the cables and connect them, that's still a manual work in a lot of cases in the production, so it's also difficult to automate it in the disassembly process.
As manufacturing technology advances, the disassembling processes can adapt accordingly.
The continuous improvement process should be established at each of these plants operating it, because with knowledge and with the volumes and with the throughput, there is more and more continuous improvement necessary.
Disassembly processes can be adapted to the progress of manufacturing technology. But it's not only the production process leading the way for the recycling process. Also, data could flow back from recycling to production.
When you store all this data historically, you can use it and process it and give feedback to the production later on. If you find out that in a certain module, maybe always certain screws on one side are damaged, that might be a feedback for construction that maybe different location would be better. So once the data is growing and the history is growing, we'll see what we can derive out of that later on.
That's a circular economy. Bosch Rexroth helps recycling companies get ready for huge amounts of batteries from electric vehicles. The first facilities using the technology are currently under construction.
From know-how to wow.
AI hosted deep dive.
In the next episode, Shuko and Geoff will stick with the topic of cars. But they'll look more at the software rather than the hardware. Imagine having a car with an API. That's coming up on June 14.